Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to an episode of Spitting Venom, aka the Venom Vlog. And today we have more coverage from Comic-Con for you guys. This time we're going to talk about an interview that was done by IGN, and then a quick little brief thing that ABC10 did. And there's a couple other red carpet things, or like when they were there after the panel, they had the Comic-Con background, and they were walking down the line, getting interviewed. I found some other clips online, so I'll link to those down below. Nothing really major was told in those. I think the only new thing of information we got was from the interview by Sydney at IGN. But at the ABC10 one, we'll talk about real quickly, there was a moment where Ruben talked about the project. I've mentioned this briefly in other videos, the previous videos, where he talked about how he was drawn to this project initially, but he really wanted Tom Hardy. He would, like, in a dream world, he's like, oh, that'd be great if Tom Hardy would do this role. And then he found out Tom Hardy was interested. Like, Sony poked around and found out that his son was a big fan, and that it made Tom Hardy interested in the project. And then they had a meeting, and then it hit it off, obviously. And they shared, you know, their ideas for the character and the vision, and then, like, the vision of the movie, and then talked about the comic book a little bit. And so that was neat to hear a little bit more about that. They don't go into full detail, Ruben doesn't, but I'll still put the clip down below if you want to see him talk and gush a little bit about Tom Hardy and what it was like working with him and how it was a dream come true in order to bring this project to life, to have Tom Hardy on board. And I think that's true. I think of Tom Hardy, once they announced that, I think it got a lot of people turning their heads toward this film. Like, I think a lot of people were like, oh, Venom, it's typical Sony. And they're like, oh, we got Ruben Fleischer. And I think some people, even for me, I was like, oh, that's cool, they got him. I love Zombieland. But I think even some people were like, whatever. It's just, it doesn't matter. And then they were like, Tom Hardy. And I think some people were like, what? Like, Tom Hardy's going to be in this? Like, okay, that's interesting. He usually picks good roles, so I want to see more. And then as they announced more cast and more crew and some of the trailers that came out, I think the first teaser lost a few people, but hopefully, the last trailer, I think, won some people over, and hopefully the new trailer coming out tomorrow will win even more people over. And I think all they're trying to do is get people to be optimistic enough to maybe go to the theater opening weekend to sit down and watch this movie. And we found out, actually, a quick bit of news, that the Mowgli movie, like the Jungle Book, studio making Jungle Book, that Mowgli movie was going to come out the same day as Venom. And so it could have been possible, slight competition, even though it's different audiences, there still would have been a group of people that might have gone to see Mowgli. And now that movie's going straight to Netflix, leaving Venom pretty much the only movie, the major movie, that's opening the weekend of October 5th. So hopefully no other movie tries to cram itself in or release early or something like that. Hopefully it's just Venom that weekend, and that would give it a good chance to make a solid amount of money that first opening weekend. I think that's what Sony's trying to bank on. They're going to start amping up that marketing and try to get people at least interested enough or optimistic enough to at least go check it out. I think that's their only goal at this point, and that's a good goal to have, because it's a pretty realistic one of just turning people's heads. That's all they want to do at this point. So these interviews helped out a lot for me, and especially with the Riot stuff. So in the IGN interview, Sydney asked Ruben about Riot, and also about the spider symbol. So let's talk about that real quick. So as we talked about in previous episodes, if you go back and watch them, one of my theories was the reason that Venom, and it wasn't even a theory, it just, to me, was a common sense kind of thing. The reason I didn't think Venom was going to have the spider on his chest was for the most obvious reason. If there's no Spider-Man in this movie, there's no reason he should have a spider on his chest. And that was pretty much, I was saying from early on, was like, I doubt we're going to get that symbol. It doesn't make any sense story-wise. And Ruben Fleischer pretty much said that verbatim in this interview. He says in the IGN interview that they did not use the spider logo because they didn't have Spider-Man. And so he said, when they were making this movie, they had all these limitations, which we talked about in previous episodes. And the biggest thing that they had to get over, not just because the character, he was like, I was pretty confident we had a good take on the character, and we had Tom Hardy who was going to deliver, and we had Riz Ahmed and Michelle Williams. He's like, I was not worried about that. What I was worried about was the visual, because Venom is a visual character. As you can see, all the art behind me, big shout out to Gray Matter Art for that. And then also we will talk about the giveaway for my extra print from Free Comic Day. We'll definitely get into that in a future episode very soon, actually. So hearing him talk about the visuals was the biggest obstacle. He said, Venom's known for his teeth and his big eyes. Some people like the tongue, some people don't. So we're going to try to balance that in the movie. The big thing was the spider on his chest. A lot of people, recognize him for being solid black with the big white spider on his chest. And he goes, that was the one obstacle visually we couldn't do. He's like, we couldn't do it for the film. He goes, so what we decided to do was we came up with this concept with the veins stretching out. He goes, but he does mention in this interview, there is a design on his chest, and it's something that's original that we came up with. We hope people like it. We'll probably see it in the next trailer. Actually, I think we do get a full body shot in this next trailer, if we're to believe some of the rumors that are out there, because some of this trailer will be some of the Comic-Con footage, but it will be tweaked and some other stuff will be added into it. But I think we will get a full full body shot finally, and you guys will get to see what this thing looks like on his chest. But it's mostly just the veins spreading out, you know, but they did want to have something there that just kind of resembled some kind of symbol, and it had a symbol of some kind. And so that is going to be included. So he did talk about that. And again, if you want to see him talk about that, that's in the interview below. I'll put the link down there for the IGN interview. But then he does go on to say about Riot. And he says, you know, with Riot, Riot can do more than Venom can. He says that Riot has abilities that Venom does not. And according to Ruben Fleischer, Venom is kind of a runt around a Riot. Riot is a bigger, more lethal symbiote. It is something with different abilities, whether he gets those abilities naturally or if it's something, you know, experimented on him at the Life Foundation, we don't know yet. But he is something different. He has different abilities. And so Venom doesn't really stack up. He's kind of an underdog. And the reason they wanted to do that is because of the backstory they came up with for the two symbiotes. So I mentioned that before in a previous episode, and this is where Ruben Fleischer talks about that. He says they originate from the same place, you know, Riot and Venom. They originate from the same place, and they have a pre-existing relationship. So there is going to be something in this movie that mentions them. So they are in themselves characters. It is not the Venom, you know, it's not just Venom, the costume, and it talks to Eddie a few times. There's a purpose for him. There's a reason. He has a backstory. He had a life, you know, on his home planet or whatever, wherever he's discovered. He had a life there, and apparently so did Riot. And they had a pre-existing relationship. They knew each other before coming to Earth and apparently didn't like each other, I'm going to guess. And so hearing that was really interesting because that was something I probably wouldn't have expected. Normally in these movies with villains, no matter if you're going to do a dark take on it or not, sometimes the villains suffer and you kind of are left wanting more with the villains. So hearing that Riz Ahmed is a kind of a fleshed out character from his interviews and him talking about what he is bringing to the table for Carlton Drake, then hearing that Riot might have a history as well with Venom and also have an arc in this movie and a reason for doing what he's doing, that is kind of neat too. And that, again, you know, makes me happy that I'm optimistic. It doesn't make me go, yay, I'm so excited, this movie's gonna be the best ever. Because I still gotta walk that line so I can, you know, deliver news to you honestly. But at the same time, it does make me feel good about being optimistic about this film, seeing how much they're putting into that. So that's really neat. And I thought, you know, what Ruben said there was awesome. And there's also some other clips I'll put down below where they talk to Riz. And if you want to see and learn a little bit more about Riz Ahmed, I highly recommend you check out his GQ interview. I'll put a link to that down below as well. There's going to be a lot of links down below, so make sure you check that out. And then also after, you know, this interview, they also did a signing. And so let's show some clips of that. We'll talk about that real quickly as well. So while the panel was going on at Comic-Con, there was actually a group of hardcore fans that were standing in line to meet Tom Hardy, Riz Ahmed, and Ruben Fleischer. So these folks didn't even get into the panel, which is a real bummer. But what they do at Comic-Con now is, because it gets really intense over there with lines and everything, you have to sign up early. So when you get your tickets online, you'll get an email saying like, hey, here's all the events that we know of, and we're gonna update this every day as we get closer to Comic-Con. So when they announced the Venom signing, they were like, okay, you know, Comic-Con was like the 20th of July, and they're like, oh, you have till the 12th, like till 9 a.m. or something like that on the 12th. So you have till then to sign up for the Venom signing. And if you sign up, doesn't mean you're gonna get it. We're gonna, you know, put it in an algorithm. We're gonna randomly choose like, you know, 50 or 100 people, and then those people will get picked, and they'll be able to meet Tom Hardy, Ruben Fleischer, and Riz Ahmed for the signing. And only they'll know where the destination for the signing is, what time it's going to be, and all that stuff. So that was, you know, kind of a bummer if you're someone who likes to, you know, if you're that rabid of a fan, you're like, I can get there early, I'll be there, whatever. You had to pretty much just be lucky on top of everything. And since I have Peter Parker's luck, I never would have, you know, it would have worked for me. I know, actually, my friend Jason Perrin, really awesome dude, in the military, very great guy. He was just in Italy for a while, came back to the States recently, came home, and he was nice enough to put his name in the hat to try to win a signed poster for me, which is super awesome of him. I mean, that is incredibly selfless. The guy's already a selfless dude. He's a very big supporter of like my writing when I used to write all the time, and he watches the show and stuff. So big shout out to him. Thank you for your service as always, Jason. You're a really awesome dude, and the fact that you even tried was super dope of you. You didn't even have to do that. But unfortunately, my bad luck rubs off on people sometimes when they try to do something nice for me. So it didn't work out for Jason, but that was very nice that he tried to do that for me. But they did have all these fans, so IGN was nice enough to go and interview these fans and talk to them, because obviously they couldn't go into the panel, which again, I feel like that's kind of a bummer. You have to choose one or the other, but that's kind of how Comic-Con is. Like when I want to do the Supernatural signings and stuff, like in previous years, it's like, all right, I either go to the panel and see all the cool stuff and see everyone there, or I go to the signing. And even the signing, it wasn't guaranteed. So it's just, and neither is getting into Hall H sometimes. That's not even a guarantee. So it's a bummer that you have to make those choices. But what is life without choices, right? So all these people were very lucky. They got to meet Tom Hardy. They got to see, you know, the actors up front, got a poster signed, which is probably way cooler than seeing the footage, because obviously they'll see the movie when it comes out and the trailer drops tomorrow, so they didn't even have to wait that long to see, you know, at least some of that footage. So that's still cool. But to see IGN give them a little bit of a shout out and see these Venom fans and put a little spotlight on them, that was really cool of IGN to do that. So if you guys are out there, you're big Venom fans, you want to see some of these other very lucky Venom fans, definitely watch that clip. I'll put a link to it down below. And as far as all the information in this episode, you know, check out links if you want. You can comment down below. We can talk about it more there. Or anything I had to say here, let me know. Are you excited about Riot getting that backstory, knowing that he's going to be, it's seemingly going to be a kind of a fleshed out character, or at least with some backstory to him, not just the any human he possesses, but the symbiote as well? I think that's pretty cool. And then what do you think of the explanation of the lack of the spider chest now that we got it official from Ruben and you're not just taking my word for it? What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching my show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff. And I got a lot more episodes to make, so let me get to it. See you in the future. Peace.